Ital, not the result we were hoping to start the new year with, but what was your assessment of the performance, first of all?
It's a shame because I think it's been a game that we didn't deserve to lose, because if a few days ago I was here speaking about the individual mistakes, once again individual mistakes have penalized us a lot. And today it's been a referee's mistakes, not just one, because everybody can think it's been just one penalty, but it's been two penalties, two real clear, real penalties. But again, even with those penalties, it's difficult to take in our situation when you are not confident at home and you have one penalty for you, and then 20 seconds later you concede one goal. It's difficult. But even with that situation, the team finished the first half much better. And then in the second half, we had the chances to score. That penalty that the referee, the linesman, and the false official didn't see, and when we were creating those chances, and one transition killed us again. So again, it's not a game to lose 2-0 for sure. But you know, this is our situation. Now we have a week to work on the training ground to prepare a nice game to play against a team like City. So keep going.
Is that the story of our season so far, that the opening minutes of the game, we're on the attack, trying to set the tone? There's a penalty that I think everybody here in attendance felt was a penalty on first viewing, isn't given, and down the other end we concede the first goal.
Yeah, and again, if I had to take something positive, is the reaction of the players. Because, you know, sometimes even when we had the scored goals, the team was going down. And today, conceding that goal after the penalty, the reaction was very good. And then it's just to keep going, because I said always that I have to trust. No, I trust in this group of players, and we will improve.
We were undone by two counter-attacking goals this afternoon. Is that exactly what you expected from Blackburn Rovers?
Yes, but you know, it's difficult because both of them have come from something that had happened on the opposite the opponent's box. Because the first one, everybody was waiting for the penalty, and then they were more intelligent than us. And the second one, when we were attacking with almost all the team, the transition was really good. So we controlled them 85-90 minutes except those two situations.
We had a couple of chances in that second half. Jonathan Lico with a strike, and then Scott Hogan gets put through, tries to round the goalkeeper and ends up thwarted. Is it those chances that we need to be taking when we're in the middle of this run?
Yes, and you know, not just us. I think every single team has no problems, but you can't see games with a lot of chances. So if you don't take your chances, it's difficult. But again, we are making mistakes defensively. We are making mistakes offensively. The referees are making mistakes, but this is football. And as I said before, we need to know that we are living a difficult moments, and we are privileged. So we have to keep going. I told the players to keep going, chins up, because again, we are the players are working really hard, and we have to keep going.
Made seven changes today. What was the thinking behind those, to freshen it up, or was it a direct response to that Derby performance?
No, it was because, you know, when I've been here for 5-6 months, and, you know, and we are not winning games at home, and the performances at home are not as good as everybody's expecting. And I was analysing, and I don't know how many games we played with 7, 8, 9 players who were here last year. And I tried to change those players. It's been a difficult decision, because players like Hartley, like Max Collins are playing really well and are really committed. So it's difficult to take those decisions. But on the other hand, I had players like Josh Cogley or Mikel San Jose, who I trust them a lot. So it's my decision, and what was the behind that decision was just to try to change as many bodies on the pitch as possible.
We're now at the halfway stage of the Championship campaign. I know you'd like more points on the board, but how do you assess where we are as a squad, as a group?
I think it's a difficult situation, because again, it's frustrating when you are working really well as they are working, when we should have had a lot of more points on the table if we hadn't made those individual mistakes, if we hadn't suffered the individual mistakes of the referees, we would have been in a completely different situation. But our situation is this, and the only way to improve the situation is keep going to there.
Final question from me. Manchester City next up in 8 days' time. Has this come at a good break in the league campaign, just to take a step back? And although it's against a formidable opposition, it might come at a good time for the group.
I think it's good to have 1 week to work on the pitch, because, you know, when you are not good and you have game by game by game, it's difficult to approach those games. Now we have a week to work on the pitch, in the training ground, to keep improving as a team, and let's see, because in those games everything can happen. You can receive 6-7 goals or you can beat them. So we are going to prepare that game in the same way that we prepare every single game, trying to beat them, knowing that it's going to be a tough game. But as a player, I think it's the kind of games that the players like to play.
Thank you, Arthur.
Thank you.